Hello, good evening. I'm Fatboy Slim. This is my journey through sound. The track I would play to explain my sound is Star 69 by me. It's got a sort of catchy vocal that means absolutely nothing and a dirty beat. That's kind of the formula of my sound. The track that last moved me was by Floor Magnet and it's called Kiss Me. And it's a really dubby, it just uses a bit of the bass line from Blue Monday, but not the bass line that you know, the dum 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 dum, that bit. It's the down, 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 down. And it's quite deep for me, but it really works. And it moves, it takes me places. It takes me sexy, interesting, moving places. The track that made me obsessed with electronic music was I Feel Love by Donna Summer. Came out in 1977 when I was a little punk rocker and we all hated disco. But this record came out and the synthesizers were just talking to me. You know I Feel Love, you know that bass line. And it was just this warm color, it was like aliens going, come into our world of lovely electronic music. And yeah, so it turned this filthy punk rocker into an electronic disco head. I would play at my best friend's wedding is the track I always play at every wedding, which is probably the reason why I don't do many weddings, is Chuck Berry and You Never Can Tell. Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. I don't know why, it gets everybody stupid dancing because they've seen the Tarantino film that's in that film, the Tarantino, you know the one. And it starts with, it was a teenage wedding and the young folks presume well. And I don't know why, it's a tune that just unites everybody, young and old, drunk and sober, into doing stupid dancing. The track I would use for a trailer, for a movie, for my life, would be the Benny Hill theme. For no other reason than I think it would set the scene of how it's felt running around being chased by half-naked nurses for most of my life. The track I listen to if I can't sleep is Paris, Texas by 𝗙𝗼𝗹𝗹𝗹. It's the soundtrack to a very beautiful film and it's just 𝗙𝗼𝗹𝗹𝗹 on slide guitar and it's just the most soothing, beautiful noise in the whole world. The track I keep putting back into my set is Born Slippy by Underworld. Kind of loved it so severely when it came out, then didn't play it for 10 years, and then would occasionally drop it. But there was a moment, one time I played it, and I could see the whole crowd just go, looking at each other going, what is this, like trying to Shazam it? And I was thinking, what is going on? This is Born Slippy. It's like one of the greatest dance records of all time. Then I realized that everyone in the crowd was about 20 years old, and this record came out 20 years ago. So, and then I learned a valuable lesson then about not dropping oldies that aren't age dependent on your team. But then one day I thought, you know what? Young people should hear this record. And so between educating the young and rewarding the old, it keeps creeping back into my set in various different remixes and mashups. I'm not sure of the actual track. The biggest curveball I've ever had on a back-to-back was from Carl Cox, where we were doing a back-to-back at Glastonbury and he left early to go and see U2. But like there was a clash. There was a clash. You know that thing where you're like, I'm gonna watch a bit of this band, but then I really want to go and that. He had in his mind that he really wanted to go and see U2. And so he just said, oh, can you do the rest? I'm gonna go and see U2. Now that was a curveball. The track that I wish I had made is Hey Boy, Hey Girl by the Chemical Brothers. It's just, it's kind of everything that Big Beat was, but also that house music was, everything that sampling is. And I suppose, coming back to my original thing about defining my sound, it's a catchy vocal that means absolutely nothing over a really filthy beat. So I suppose I've spent half my career trying to recreate that record.